Now we're going to go over to our Kwon So-wha, who is standing by at the Jindo Indoor Auditorium down in the coastal city. So it's been over 36 hours since the vessel began to capsize, and there's a sense of every precious minute passing by without any results from the rescue mission. How are the families of those who are missing holding up?
Sean, the hundreds of families that are gathered here at the Jindo Indoor Auditorium really don't have any other focus than waiting for any bits of new information. The atmosphere at this hour is relatively calm, but from time to time I hear parents crying out for their children and hoping for their loved ones to return safely to them. And earlier I saw a woman screaming out that she received a text message which may have come from her child, and some people even fainted. Around 500 volunteers, including nurses, are helping out, and companies and civic groups like the Red Cross and welfare foundations are supplying families with relief supplies, including food, water, raincoats, hot packs, and blankets. Sean?
So President Park Geun-hye was on site to comfort the families and answer questions. Was she able to put more pressure on the search?
Well, yes, at around 4:20 p.m., President Park arrived at the auditorium to talk with the families and consult them. She vowed to help in any possible way and that she called for the utmost effort to the rescue crews. The families, however, had many questions and mixed emotions filled the gym. Some were skeptic about the rescuers, saying whenever they went to the site, they did not see the hundreds of divers that were supposed to be there to help. Now, when one became outraged about the fact that the families were learning more about the rescue situations by watching the news, people joined by shouting angrily. And that's why President Park has assured them that a television screen will be sent to the auditorium for live observation. And since a few hours ago, one has appeared and families are gathered around it. Meanwhile, some families have taken shuttle buses to Pengmok Harbor to watch the search and rescue efforts with their own eyes. And the buses are running every hour. That's all I have for now, but I'll be back with more later on. Back to you, Sean.
All right, thank you, So-wha. That's our Kwon So-wha reporting live from the Jindo Indoor Auditorium, where she's with the families of the missing passengers who are desperately waiting for hopeful news.